Welcome friends, I'm Will Woodfield with W3 Productions. Thank you to everyone that watched the last tutorial about dynamic paint. This one's going to be in a similar vein, showing specifically how to use dynamic paint to create footsteps and terrain. Starting out in Blender 2.8, we're going to go ahead and delete the default cube. I'm going to change this light to a sun in case we need to show shadows to help us see our footprints. So going to this tab and then clicking on sun, our terrain is going to be somewhere over here, so I'm going to drag the direction of the sun across the terrain. For our footsteps, I'm going to be importing a character from Dash Studio that's already animated to walk, so your character or object may differ. Let's go ahead and set up our collections so that our objects will be organized. In the outliner, I'm going to right click, new collection. Let's call the first collection character. Call another collection terrain. And let's go ahead and save our file, especially because in order to save the dynamics calculations, the cache, we'll need to save the file first. That's also good to save often. So let's go ahead and import our character. Going to File, Import FBX. And as I've said in other videos, in order to bring in a Genesis character via FBX, you have to uncheck pre-post rotation, check automatic bone orientation. And in this specific case, I want the character to be larger so that the feet or the shoes are larger and cover more vertices or cover a wider area versus creating more vertices in a smaller space. So I'm going to use a value of 5 for the scale. Let's go ahead and import. Now we see we have a character that walks forward for about 140 frames. I'm going to go ahead and limit our scene to 140 frames. And we are going to go ahead and create our terrain. So Shift A, plane. Go ahead and change the name to terrain. We are also going to notice that I didn't put anything in the right collection. Well, I put the characters in the right collection, but our terrain didn't make it there. So I'm going to drag this down to the terrain collection. I just want to name it correctly. So there. We need to scale it up by about 10. So S, 10, enter. We need to give it more geometry so that the displacements can happen. We only have 4 vertices right now at each corner. I will hit tab to go into enter edit mode. Hit W for the vertex context menu. Subdivide. And I am going to use the value of 100 cuts because that's the max that you can use at a time. And then I believe I'm going to subdivide again to get even more geometry for a better footprint. And I'm going to leave that value at 1. We don't want any more vertices here. I want our terrain to look more terrain-like without messing with materials. I just want to mess with the texture of it, so to speak. So I'm going to add a displacement modifier to give it more of a wavy look rather than just a flat plane. So in the modifiers tab, I'm going to add modifier, displace, using a strength value of 0.05. We need a texture for this displacement, so I will use new texture, call that new texture terrain. Head over to the terrain tab with terrain already selected as our texture and change the type from image or movie to clouds. And we see we have more of a field or rocky terrain at play. Let's go ahead and move it over a little bit on the y-axis. GY, and then set it right there. I'm going to hit 3 for side view, then 5 for orthographic view. What I'm checking for is to make sure that as a character walks, that the feet actually break the plane in order for the footsteps to occur. I don't really think that's happening right now, so I need to move the terrain up just a little bit to meet the feet. So GZ, holding shift down, I'm going to move the terrain up just slightly. Alright. Next, I will add the dynamic paint physics to the terrain and also to the shoes of the character, which will leave the footprints. Say the character only didn't have shoes, or everything was part of the character as one mesh, I would add it to the mesh itself. So with the canvas, well, this will be our canvas with the terrain selected. Let's go to the physics tab, click on dynamic paint, leave the type as canvas, add canvas. We see here, because I limited the number of frames in the scene, the end frame is now 140. And that's going to be important when you're baking dynamics. You don't want to bake too many frames if you don't need them in your scene. I want to use the substeps value of, let's say, 5. Let's change the surface type from paint to displace. The displacement factor I want to use is 2. I only want objects from the character collection to affect this canvas, so I will select the character collection. And now for the brush, which is our shoes, I'm going to click on the casual shoe shape. Dynamic paint, change type to brush, add brush. I like to use the paint type of mesh volume plus proximity. So I will select that. And let's go ahead and scrub through the timeline and see what happens. Zooming in here, let's go ahead and go to object. Make sure we have our terrain selected, object, shade smooth. And we see we have some footprints in the terrain. And we can mess with different things to get different results, better results, or more appropriate results. We could add more vertices to the canvas, which would be more calculation intensive. We could mess with the displacement factor, the max displacement, the displacement factor, the number of sub-steps, so on and so forth. If you're doing a lot more than what we're doing here, you would want to bake your dynamics so that that'll be saved. But this would be the gist of what you're looking for if you wanted to create footprints in an object in Blender 3D. So I hope that you found this helpful. Be sure to give a like and subscribe. If you have any ideas or anything you want to share, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Have a blessed day.